Welcome back to Win the Day. My name is Jacob Wirka. Today we'll be looking at Hebrews and looking at the idea of how Jesus is everything that we need. If you've spent any time on the internet at all, then I'm sure you've seen all sorts of different life hack videos. Now, I don't know about you, but when I see some of those life hacks and how effective their tips and tricks are, then I can't believe that I've never thought of them myself. Once I see that there's a better way to do something, I can't imagine going back to the old way of doing things because I know that there's a better and an easier way. Now, this idea of finding a better way, or maybe a superior way, is what the book of Hebrews is all about. Now, I think we should read this book because it gives us multiple examples of how Jesus is not only the fulfillment of the Old Testament, but also the new and better way, the better way for humanity to connect to God. Not only the better way, but honestly, he's the only way. Now, the interesting thing about the book of Hebrews is that we don't actually know the author. We also don't know the specific audience that they're writing to. However, based on what's written, we know that this author assumes that the audience knows their Old Testament and knows it really well. And it appears that this is a group of Christians who are wrestling with the idea of leaving Christianity and going back to the former Jewish laws and customs from the Old Testament. And we know that this book was written somewhere between 68 and 70 AD, around the time of Nero, when he had been Caesar of the Roman Empire. And Nero is famous for his devastating persecution against Christians, which could have been tempting this audience to abandon their faith and go back to the Jewish customs so they didn't have to experience all of that torture. But notable people we find in the book of Hebrews include many Old Testament figures that are mentioned, including Abraham and Moses and Melchizedek, along with, of course, Jesus. But I think we can specifically see Jesus in this book of Hebrews all throughout the book. The main idea is the author is trying to demonstrate how Jesus is superior to all the different ways of connecting to God that were found in the Old Testament. Hebrews shows us that Jesus is better or superior to the angels, the priests, the prophet, the entire sacrificial system. Jesus is a better way than any of those former things. And now a key passage that highlights this theme is found in chapter 4, verses 14 through 16. Since then, we have a great high priest who's passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast to our confession, for we do not have a high priest who's unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. This is the big takeaway that we should find from the book of Hebrews. Jesus is our great high priest, who like a bridge connects humanity to God. Now, here is a priest who can sympathize with us because he knows what it's like to be a human being. Every temptation and every trial that we face, Jesus understands. And through his death and resurrection, we now have access to the throne of God. So now we can draw near to him through the perfection of Jesus. So even when we face trials or persecutions for being a Christian, we must hold fast to our faith in Jesus. There is no other way. There is no better way. There is no life hack that can get us back to God other than Jesus. So don't fall away from faith. Don't go back to your former ways of doing things. Go and follow Jesus with all that you have, because he has provided everything that we need to bring us back to God. So here's my challenge for you today. Now, we all have times where we fall and we fail, and we think about how difficult it is to follow Jesus. We might even be tempted to want to go back to our former ways of life. But I want you to look to Jesus. I want you to know that he's right there with you, and he understands those struggles that you're going through. He can give you everything that you need to keep going, because in Jesus, we have everything that we need.